Hi there. So our next topic is a very important topic, and most of the questions you will find from this topic. So that is the formulas for E, tan psi and delta. How to find out the delta? If you see the any previous year question paper, so you will find the questions related to this one. So here I will discuss generate for generator and motor and at one at a time. So first of all we will discuss for generator, and later we will discuss for a motor here. Okay, so for generator, generated EMF per phase, okay, generated EMF per phase is equal to V at an angle 0, this is also phase, plus IA at an angle plus or minus 5 into Z at an angle theta. Okay, so how we got this one is, so this is a generated EMF. Here we got generated EMF. It is at an angle delta. So this is a delta. The load angle. Delta is equal to here some resistance are there and some reactance are there. Here we are at an angle 0 degrees, and this is the load connected. So because of the load, so in the question they will mention whether this is a lagging load or leading load. Based on that only you are taking this. So calculate IA from here, based on the given data, loaded data. And from that IA, so this is combinedly this is a Z at an angle theta. Okay, so suppose if IA is given lagging power factor, then IA is at an angle minus 5. Take IA as an angle minus 5. If the IA is given leading power factor, then IA at an angle take plus 5. That's it. So and substitute in it and find out the solution for that. So you can simplify this one. V phase at an angle 0 degrees plus, so this is IA into Z. If these two are combined, then at an angle theta plus or minus 5, that is equal to V phase at an angle 0 degrees plus IA into Z. So you can apply cos theta. Actually in grade we don't have the calculator to solve these type of problems, so that's why I converted into the rectangular coordinates. So theta plus or minus 5 plus j sine theta plus or minus 5. So after you will get like solution is like a plus j plus or minus jb. So a plus or minus jb. So if you want the magnitude of E, so then take root over a square plus b square. And if you want the angle, that is a tan delta. Now then, if you want the angle, tan delta is equal to so b by a plus or minus b by a. That's it. So if you got angle, see whether you got the angle positive or negative. So see, for the generator mostly you will get mostly not a positive angle for the generator, and for motor will get the negative angle, negative load angle for the generator. And one more formula that is handy, that is E phase is equal to root over, so this is a magnitude, root over V phase cos phi load power factor plus IA phase RA whole square plus V phase sine phi load power factor plus or minus IA phase excess whole square. Okay, we can use this formula directly for calculating the magnitude of E phase for generator. But for calculating, like if you use this formula, you can get directly E magnitude of E and the load angle. But for the from this formula, we will only get E only, that's the magnitude of E. So we won't able to get the delta value. So for that, we need to have one more formula. So that is a tan psi. That is tan psi is equal to V phase, all our phases, V sine phi L plus or minus IA XS divided by V cos phi L plus IA RA. So from this answer, you can able to calculate the delta value. So I will discuss later this. if you get the psi value, psi value is the internal angle. So how you will getting delta value, I will discuss after discussing the motor. Now let us discuss about the motor. Again, I am not able to repeating all these things. Just you want the generated voltage or EMF minus delta per phase, that is equal to V phase at an angle 0 degrees minus same thing IA the angle plus or minus phi into Z at an angle theta. Same thing here, plus phi for leading load and minus phi for lagging. The next one is direct formula. See, the only difference is if I use this formula, so minus phi is for lagging load and plus phi for leading load. But if you use this formula, so most of the people confuse there only. If you use this formula, okay, so for lagging load we are taking plus phi and for leading load we are taking minus phi. Why? Because while drawing the phasor diagram, all components, this phi component, psi component, all are below. So all are actually negative. But like we are not interested to see that many negatives in our phasor diagrams. So that's why we are converting that one into that. And again, after that, we are solving this formula. So that's why for lagging load, take as a plus phi and minus. So the better to use this formula. Okay, you won't get any problem, any confusion whether it is a motor or the generator. So same thing for both. So suppose if you want to use this formula, E phase is equal to root V phase cos phi L minus IARA whole square. This is also phase, remember, plus V phase sin phi L minus or plus IA. Okay, so here also just compare these two formulas. Here for plus, like plus IARA component, will get the plus, but here you get the minus. So remember plus and minus. Okay, so related this to lagging. Okay, so here you are getting the plus for lagging, so here you get a negative for lagging. That's why you are getting negative here also, negative and positive. So here negative means for lagging power factor, this is negative. For positive means for the leading power factor. Likewise tan psi also, tan psi is equal to V cos phi, sorry, this is V sin, V phase sin phi L, okay, minus or plus IA XS divided by V phase cos phi L. Here we will get the minus, okay, IARA. So again, compare these two formulas. Here we get the plus or minus, here you will get the minus or plus, same. So here we are getting the plus. Why? Because here we are taking for lagging load plus, and here for lagging load we are taking minus. So as for this formula, but if you consider this formula and this formula, there is no confusion at all. So try to use these two formulas, okay, rather than remembering all these formulas. And the next one is for salient pole machine. Okay, for salient pole machine, so what is the tan psi value and how to calculate the E value and tan psi value? Okay, there is a quite some different between these two. For this is all for cylindrical machines, but for salient pole machine, E you can calculate by using the V phase cos delta. So I am taking for generator first, and later I will give the formula for motor. So V phase cos delta plus IARA plus IARA plus or minus ID XT. So this is for generator, and I will give you the trick to remember this one also. And next one is for motor. So E phase is equal to V phase cos delta, here minus IARA minus or plus d xd. Okay, so here this xd and id and xd are the actually in salient coordinations we have the two axes. One is the direct axis and is the quadrature axis. So this is a direct axis reactance and this is a direct axis current. So let us see this id and xd. So see, actually for salient formation we have the xd and xq. Okay, so xd is equal to actually xd is actually greater than the xq, that is xd minus xq is approximately equal to 1.5. okay, so I'll calculate an e is equal to v phase cos delta, this is for generator, v phase cos delta plus IARA plus or minus ID XT. So here we will get the formula problem. Like in question they will give the XT, but they won't give the ID and they won't give the delta. Okay, so we need to calculate these two. So this is given, but these are two unknowns. One is ID and the ID and the delta. So for that, first of all, we need to calculate tan psi. Tan psi is equal to V sin phi plus or minus IA XQ divided by V cos phi plus IA RA. So remember, so this is the armature current and this is the XQ and this is IA RA. I thought you already remember this one, plus or minus, where to given plus or minus, where to minus. If taken as a motor, that is a minus to plus. If you take it as a generator, that is a plus to minus. That's it. Next one is, so from this we will get the psi value. Okay, now from this psi value we have to calculate the delta value. So how you are able to calculate the delta value, this is a load power factor actually. So delta value you will see here. So this is a generator. Okay, based on whether the given power factor is lagging power factor or leading power factor, the delta value formula will be changed. So but no need to remember that one, that formula. Just make a phasor diagram and draw the result from it. Suppose if I am giving the lagging power factor, so remember in generator EZ is always leading than V, other poles also. So this is EZ, so we are having, this is V and this is IA. Just I'm drawing fastly. This is delta and this is V and phi, this is a phi angle between IA and this is a psi. So from this, this is a psi is a bigger angle. So find out, write the formula for psi. Psi is equal to this angle to this angle, delta plus phi. From this, delta is equal to psi minus phi. So this is the formula for lagging. Likewise for leading also, I'm drawing quickly. This is that voltage is always lagging generated voltage, and this is current is leading. Sorry, current is leading here. Don't be here. So angle between these two is psi, and angle between these two is phi, and angle between V and this one is delta. Okay, so this is bigger angle is delta. So write on the formula for delta. Delta is equal to psi plus phi. That's it. Here you will get the minus phi. Delta minus phi, delta plus phi. Simple, you can remember like that. Delta is equal to psi plus or minus for the generator case. And for motor, let's see the formula for motor also. E is equal to V phase cos delta minus or plus ID XT. Okay, I forgot to say one thing. Okay, I will discuss here. IA, RA and tan psi is equal to same. V sin phi L minus or plus IA XQ divided by V cos phi L minus IA RA. Here we need this one ID value. So, but here you got the delta value, so that's fine. Delta value you got, but we need the ID value. So simply, if you want ID value, so that is ID is a direct axis. So direct axis, in question they will give the IA value, IA sin psi, and for IQ. So quadrature axis current, but you are not requiring this one. IA cosine. So this is a quadrature axis. You can find the these formulas in any standard textbook. I can refer the PS Bhimra. There we have the phasor diagram. So from that we are deriving this. So just watch the phasor diagram, but not required for here, as I am discussing only formulas. So from this you can calculate the E value also for salient pole machine. And one more thing I forgot to say here. Okay, got all these formulas. So here, yeah, actually in motor phasor diagram is, so for here also we need delta. Here we can calculate delta from this formula. So plus or minus, so plus for lagging and minus for leading. And here this is V. Actually you are giving the supply V, because of that you are getting generated EG. So this is EG. Okay, angle between these two is delta. And suppose if you take for lagging load, this is IA. If you see V and IA, this is phi, and these two, angle between these two is delta. So this is the psi. So larger angle is delta. So delta is equal to psi plus phi for lagging load. And for, okay, so and for leading load also. So this is V and this is IA and this is EG. Angle between these two is delta and these two is phi, these two is psi. Psi is equal to delta plus phi. So from this delta is equal to psi minus phi. Okay, I thought we are getting. We are going to discuss next topic in the next video. Okay, and trick. That's the last one. This is the most interesting. This is a short trick. Like I have the sentence for remembering. Like when I am solving these type of questions, I am not able to remember these formulas. Like whether I got the doubts, like whether I have to substitute here sin phi or cos phi, and here also cos phi or sin phi. Here I'm always always forgetting to, like whether it is a xq or xt. Most of the time I am making mistakes here only. So for remembering that one, I'm using the funny thing. Just use this sentence, that is daddy scan QR code to buy aquarium. That's it. So if you remember this, how it will be useful, I'll say this is D and D, here QR. And this is AQ. So D it is a IDXT. So in this formula we have the IDXT, so like that. And QR, this is IQ and RA, QR, and this is IAXQ. That's it. So here we got the IAXQ and IARA. IQRA, sorry, this is IQRA. And this is IQRA. Here also IQRA. That's it. So by using these formulas, so we can do the any type of problems related to the salient pole machine or normal cylindrical machine also. So let's switch to the next formula later in the next video.